If you don't master your time, the truth is you're never going to make the transition out of your 9-to-5 job into having your own company. In today's video, I want to show you how to be able to have a job, grow your business, and have a life all in one day. How can I tell you this? Because I did it. I worked in corporate America for years before becoming a full-time entrepreneur, and I want to show you the thought process of those that have successfully made the jump. So let's go ahead and get started. Now, the first thing that you say when it comes to how do I work a job? How do I grow my business? How do I have a social life? How do I take care of my family? The first thing that comes to mind as soon as you say that is there's not enough hours in a day. And it feels like it's not. But let's see if that's true. I want you to look right here in this section right here. This represents your time. You got 24 hours in a day. And you know, whether you're rich or poor, we all have the exact same time. Time is the great equalizer. So you have 24 hours in a day. And I'm giving you the benefit of the doubt in this video that 8 of those hours are spent sleeping. And you and I both know it's not, but I just want to show you how much time you really have that you're just taking for granted every single day. So if we do some basic math, you take away 8 from 24, that's 16. You work a typical 9-to-5 shift, that's another 8 hours, right? So you've gone from 24 to 16 to 8. Now let's say that you have a 2-hour commute, which is what the average person in America has coming to and from work. Now you've went down from 8 to 6. And maybe it might take you about an hour or so to get ready to go to work, putting on your clothes, showering, getting some breakfast. You still have 5 remaining hours in a day, even after all of those things. And so here's what I want you to think about. You know, where is all of the extra time going after all of these different areas have been accounted for? I've already given you 8 hours of sleep. I've assumed that you're working 8 hours every single day and that you have a 2-hour commute, for some people more, for some people less. So what is taking up all your time? See, if you're going to be successful when it comes to you actually transitioning out of your 9-to-5 and having your own business, the first thing that you have to change is your mindset. Before your bank account can change, your mindset must change. And so the first thing that I would suggest that you do, as I did when I was working in my 9-to-5, is put yourself in the mentality of pay yourself first. Now, what does that mean, Uzziah? We're talking about time. Pay yourself first means this. Your time is the most valuable asset that you have. That coupled with your energy in life. Because see, you could always spend more money. But time, once you spent that, you're not going to get that hour back. And everybody knows the significance of managing their money, but what about managing your time? See, when you talk about paying yourself first in a monetary sense, that means before anybody else gets paid, you get paid. There's a portion of your resources that goes into your bank account to make sure that you're taken care of. But why don't you do that with your time? How often do you wake up every single day just to get dressed to go to work? And right before you gotta be at the job, that's when you're waking up and you're racing out of the door. How many times do you wake up right before you have to go to work? You don't give yourself any extra time. You don't give yourself any extra space. You literally sleep down to the last second before you know that you have to get up at that time after you didn't hit the snooze button a few times in order to go to work. You've got to pay yourself first, man. This is what you got to do. In order for you to pay yourself first, that means before you go to work for somebody else, why not go to work for yourself? If you're going to expend the best energy of your day working on building up somebody else's empire, well, why not get up just a little bit earlier to focus on making an investment in building your own empire? You know, when I was working at a 9-to-5 job, I definitely felt the strain of having to get up, having to get dressed. Okay, I'm on this routine. I gotta be able to make this commute, do all of those things. But it wasn't until I started to discipline myself to wake up about 3 to 4 hours before I even had to go to work that my business actually started to change. Because here's what a lot of you guys are trying to do. You say that you want to have a business, right? So you'll go to work from 9 to 5. You'll deal with customers you don't like. You'll deal with employees that you don't like. You'll deal with a boss you can't stand. You don't like the commute. You don't like what you do. So by the time that you get back from work and you get home after a hard day's commute, you find yourself burned out. And the last thing that you want to do, and that time is build a business, you're just more so focused on just taking a load off and watching TV. You want to spend time with family. You want to be able to talk with friends. You want to be able to have some type of enjoyment out of your life. And all of this is because you're postponing the most significant activities of the day towards the time period where you actually have the lowest energy within that day, with for your time. See, the things that require the best of you should get done the earliest. The things that require the most focus, that will give your life the most impact, those are the things that should be getting done first. So again, when it comes to you putting in hours, whether it be at work or wherever else you gotta be, do not pay anyone else with your energy and with your time until you have paid yourself first. I would not go to a 9-to-5 job, and I don't care how well they're paying you. If I knew that I wanted to be able to have my own business and all of this is what I did do, I would get up every single day and I would put my best energy, my best brain power into those efforts before I even allowed my boss to be able to get the best of me. No, you're going to get the mid-level of me. Okay, I'm not going to slouch off to the point where I get fired, but I'm not going to give you my best. The best I'm going to put in myself. Pay yourself first when it comes to time. And the second point is you got to know how to run the block. What do I mean when I say run the block? You've got to understand that if something is important to you, you'll make a way. If not, you'll make an excuse. So a lot of times what happens is, you know, people just go through life in a daze. You wake up, you just kind of go where the wind blows. If somebody's sending you a text, you respond. If somebody is calling you, you answer. You don't really have that rigid of a schedule, because even having that rigid of a schedule feels like work. Here's what I'm going to encourage you to do. Instead of mapping out, you know, every single hour of the day down to the second, I want you to just start creating time blocks around the most important things that you do, okay? You don't have to have something on the schedule about what time you take out the dog, what time you take out the trash, what time you're gonna go into the fridge and drink whatever it is that you're about to drink. You don't need all of those things on your planner. What you need is 1 to 2 set hours of a time block every single day where you're working on your business. And like I said, even if you're operating off of this list right here, you still got 5 hours. Now, if your business is important to you and making the exit out of that 9-to-5 is important, I'm pretty sure you could get 1 to 2 hours out of a day to be able to make an investment in your business. You're either going to make a way or you're going to make an excuse. And everybody says that they want to be successful in business, but they always have a million reasons as to why they cannot dedicate 1 to 2 hours out of a 24-hour day to make that step forward in their life. You know, so many people come to me, they say, Uzziah, I want to be successful. Uzziah, I want to be able to work with you. Uzziah, I want to know what it takes to be able to change the game. I want to be able to work from home. I want to be able to travel the world. But then when it comes to the time that it takes to actually carve out the energy and the effort to learn how to get it done, you know what those same people say? Oh, well, you know, so much is going on in my life right now. You know, I'm so busy working at this job I don't want to be at that I don't have the time to actually learn how to build the life that I do want to live. Oh, well, you know, I just don't have the time and I don't have the this and I don't have the that. Listen, all of that is excuses. I don't care who you are watching this video. You and I both know all of that is excuses. You make time for every other thing that you value in your life. If you value this enough, you'll make the time for it, okay? And in that 1 or 2 hours that you give yourself when it comes to your work, I want you to go into that 1 or 2 hour time block during a day with 3 core objectives on what you're gonna do for your business, okay? Don't just wander throughout that 1 or 2 hour business shift. So you might have freed up the time, and then once you get that 1 or 2 hours, you say, okay, Uzziah, well, I've got this 1 or 2 hours. Well, what do I do now? How do I get started? Before the shift even starts, you should have already thought about that. Set goals. Top 3 daily goals. Okay, I'm going to make X number of phone calls. I'm going to reach out and follow up to X number of leads. Okay, I'm going to work on setting up X number of negotiations. Whatever the case may be, whether you're going to work on your website, whether you're going to work on your next big product, whatever you need to do to move your business forward, you really need to list out the top 3 most important things that you need to be doing to get the job done for your company. And you need to be spending those 1 to 2 hours focused relentlessly on getting those things done, all right? And if you are willing to dedicate yourself to getting this job done, then guess what? You will be able to have the time to work at your 9-to-5 job while growing your company, while having a life. I can tell you that because I did it. I am the living proof. I'm just simply giving to you the formula that I used to transition out of working in corporate America to being able to have my own business that allows me to be able to work from home, travel the world, all while replacing the income that I had when I was in corporate America, all right? So if you wanna know in a lot more detail how to be able to transition out of your 9-to-5 job into your very own business where you're gonna be your own boss, having the freedom to work where you wanna work and do the things that you wanna do, I want you to go to the link below or tap the card above. I'm going to actually give a free gift to you from me, a step-by-step training on all of the things that I did to make the exit out of corporate America, okay? It's not just about you knowing how to manage your time. You've got to know how to manage your money. You've got to know how to manage your energy. You've got to know how to invest in your own learning in order to learn the things that are necessary for you to become a real entrepreneur, okay? You're not going to do it all on your own. If you think that you're just going to wake up one day and then instantly you know what it takes to be able to make 5 figures, 6 figures, 7 figures, trust me, you've got another thing coming, okay? If you want to know how to be able to set up your business the right way so that you can quit your 9-to-5 job, I want you to go to this link or tap the card above because I'm going to show you how to do that step by step. All right? So here's something that I want you to do. Leave me a comment. After you leave me this comment, I want you to tell me what your time breakdown looks like and how you're going to start incorporating that time block of 1 to 2 hours in a day for you to actually make the jump out of your 9-to-5 so that way you can continue to grow your company, okay? What are you doing with your time right now? How are you going to make room for 1 or 2 hours of working on your business on top of having a life and a job? Okay. And I want to see what those results are going to look like for you. If you could actually commit yourself to doing this for a year, I think that you would get some real good results. Stay focused. All right. This is something that can change your life, your family, your legacy, but it's all up to you to do it. I can't force you to do it. All I can do is show you the way. You can lead a horse to water, but you can't make him drink. All right. Leave me a comment. Subscribe to this channel. Share this video with a friend. And I'll see you on the next episode. Take care.